Hello everyone. In this lecture, let us look up various IPM practices followed against mango pest. This plant, normally referred as the king of fruit, in the crop development, it was attacked by so many pests. See the important varieties of mango in this slide: Sendoora, Banganapalli, Alfonsa, Bangalore, Needham, Payur 1. The pest were broadly classified into two categories. One is pest of national significance and pest of regional significant, right? If you look at the national significant, there are so many pest, important pest in the national significant. First one is mango hopper and mango mealybug and fruit fly, stem borer, stone weevil, leaf weber, inflorescence midge and red ant. It's also pest. Indirect pest. Okay, coming to regional significance: scale, shoot pepper, termites and thrips. Let's see one by one. First one is inflorescence feeder, the hopper. It comprises three species complex, right? It is quite serious to mango, or specific to mango, right? Here the species are Idioscopus niveosparsus, Idioscopus clypealis, Amritodus atkinsoni, family Cicadellidae, order Hemiptera. Sometimes some species are dominant. They are quite specific to only mango and mainly attack to on flowering stage. And in off season, they are normally seen on bark or on branches or on leaves. And once the tree are flowering, especially February to April or number to February, then the population of hoppers shifted to inflorescence to cause a heavy damage. Here there are two type of damage caused by the hopper. That is, first one is direct, second one is indirect. What is that? First one is suck the cells up directly, it will cause the damage. And second one is indirectly, it causes oviposcional punctures and secrete the honeydew secretion, right? Here, this secretion is reason for the formation of fungi, which leads to sooty mold and result in reduction in photosynthesis, right? Let's see the biology of hoppers. Here, egg period is 4 to 7 days. Here, it lays down singly into the plant tissue of young leaves and shoots, flower, stalk and unopened flower. It around 200 eggs per female. Nymphal stage is 8 to 13 days. Adult stage is about 3 weeks. And it is light greenish to brown with black and yellow marking. It is a wedge shape. It is confined to only hoppers, wedge shape, right, with broad head. Total life cycle is 3 weeks. You can see the different type of hoppers stages in the pictures. And present in bottom side of leaves also, right. Coming to the differentiation about the species complex of hoppers in mango. First one is Idioscopus niveosparsus. Color is light brownish and smaller, and light brown and smallest in the case of Idioscopus clypealis, and light brown and biggest in size in the case of Amritodus atkinsoni. For number of spots on scutellum, it is 3 in the case of Idioscopus niveosparsus and 2 in the case of both Idioscopus clypealis and Amritodus atkinsoni. Other characters are, you can see in the slide. These are the special character differentiation among the species of hoppers in mango. And 50 to 60% loss due to the hopper. Here adult oviposit from the middle of February to March on the floral tissue. They remain active throughout the year, but the incidence is severe during the month from February to April and November to February. Here adult lay eggs on flowers but and inflorescence stalk. Adult and nymphs suck sap from flowers and causing drying of flowers and subsequent dropping and severe honeydews, and the result sooty mold develop, causing a less photosynthesis effect. Heavy puncturing and continuous draining of saps causing curling and also drying of infested tissue. It is in 3 to 4 generation completed in a growing season, with a population built up in February to April and June to August. Okay. Here hoppers shelters in the cracks, cervix of the bark or underside of leaves of trees during this off-season. A sooty mold formation on mango leaves due to the mango hopper infestation. It is considered as a secondary symptom, and is the sooty mold is also caused by the mango mealy bug, for your information. And coming to management, we can go for resistant variety or avoid the susceptible varieties. Here resistant varieties like Bangnapalli or Chinnarasam and Alfonso, and avoid close planting. And good orchard management practices such as keeping the orchard clean, regular ploughing, removal of weeds, and pruning of overcrowded and overlapping branches in the month of December will reduce the hopper population. And collect and destroy the affected inflorescence, spray NSK 5% and neem oil 5 ml per liter, and spray insecticide molecules like imidacloprid, thiamethoxam, and avoid, you can avoid the synthetic pyrethroid. And also go for the lambda cyclothrin, imidacloprid, thiamethoxam, dimethyl, delta methrin, buprofezin, monocrotophos, malathion, etc. Okay, you can go for any one of the listed chemical. And coming to flower rubber, Eublema versicolor, family Noctuidae, order Lepidoptera. Here biology is egg, larva, pupa, adult. Egg is about 5 days, larva is 18 to 20 days, and pupa is 8 to 9 days. Here male moth. It is a purplish pink or light orange wing without apical patches. Female is purplish gray wing. And coming to management, we remove and destroy the affected flowers with the larvae. And we can go for chloripyrifos 20 EC 1 ml per liter, Vaseline 35 EC 0.07%. Coming to borer, the fruit fly, Bactrocera dorsalis. Family Tapetidae, order Diptera. It is otherwise called oriental fruit fly. Okay. You can note the symptom, right? The female punctures the outer wall of mature fruits, which is pointed ovipositor and inside egg inside the mesocarp of mature fruit. After hatching, the larva feeds on pulp of fruits, which disappear normally from outside but drop down finally. The mature maggot fall down into the soil for pupation. The emergence of fruit fly start from April onwards, and the maximum population is recorded during May to July, which coincide with the fruit maturing. Right. Here, what about the control practices? The prior to harvest, the collect and dispose of infested and fallen fruits to prevent further multiplication on and carry over the population. The ploughing of orchard during November to December to expose pupa to sunset heat, which kill them. If infestation is heavy, bite splash on tree trunk only, and once or twice at weekly interval is recommended. And to prepare the bait splash, mix 100 gram of jaggery in 1 liter of water and 1 to 2 ml of delta methrin by using an old broom. Then managing fruit flies also reduce the mango anthracnose disease and prevent late fruit fall. The physical control is hot water treatment, about 48 plus or minus 1 degree Celsius for 4 to 5 minutes. Here mechanical control is male annihilation technique. What is that? Here setup of fly trap using methyl eugenol. Prepare methyl eugenol 1 ml per liter of water plus 1 ml of malathion solution. Take a 10 ml of mixture per trap. Keep them different places in 1 hectare between 6 and 8 a.m. morning. Collect and destroy the adult. Next one is mango nut or stone weevil, Sternocetes mangiferae, Curculianidae, Coleoptera. It is a monophagous pest mango having 5 larval instar. Also important point, it has adult hibernation. That means resting stage of adult. nut weevil. It is a common pest of mango in southern India. Varieties with high TSS and sugar such as Alfonso, Bangalore or Neelam etc. are more prone to attack by the pest. Female laid under the rind of ripening fruit, newly emerged grubs bore through the pulp, feed on seed coat and later cause damage to cotyledon. Pupation takes place inside the seed. Pulp is discolored around the affected portion. The pulps adjacent to the affected stone is seen discolored when the fruit is cut off. Here, stories weevils spend the winter living under the loose bark around the base of mango trees or in the fork of branches. They are also living in the leaf litter around the trees. Approximately 25% of adult overwinter in the seed. Here adult weevils can live for 2 years. So even with a crop failure in this one season, some weevil can strive into the following year. During flowering, the adult weevils leave the sheltered area under loose tree bark and litter under the trees and move into the outer canopy of the tree to feed on new growth and to mate prior to egg laying. You can see the biology of nut weevil, egg grub, pupa adult. Their egg period is 7 days. Their egg lays in singly. Grub period is 20 to 30, creamy yellow apodous grub. Pupal period is 7 days, pupation takes inside the nut. It's the peculiar one, inside the nut. And adult stone weevil and dark brown in color. Adult longevity is 10 months. Peanut size fruit. The eggs are elongated and creamy white. At laying, the weevils cut a very small nick into the fruit and the resulting the sap flow cover the egg cases. This helps to protect the eggs and adhere to them to fruit. Several eggs may be laid on each fruit and each female can lay up to 15 eggs per day and up to 300 eggs during the season. Let's imagine. Right, okay. Coming to management, collection and destruction, bagging. Avoid the varieties like Neelam and Bangalore. Use Pentheon. Spray at marble stage, the marble stage, that is a focused stage. This and second spray should be the 2 weeks after first spray. Take up the insecticide spray directing towards the base of trunk during the non-flowering season. During non-flowering season, direct spray to towards the base of the trunk. You can also go for Demeter spray and carbaryl or osaprey. Then coming to stem borer, Batazera, Rufa maculata, Cerambycidae, or Coleoptera. It is otherwise called longicorn beetle. You can see compound eyes are notched. See the picture. Pronotum is one having 1 to 3 lateral spines. The antennae is longer than body. Grubs are apodous, elongated, cylindrical, whitish, and bore into the stem. The grub feed by the tunneling the bark of the branches and the main stem. The shedding of leaves and drying of terminal shoots take place in the early stage of attack, while damaging to main stem causes tree death. Chewed food matter along with the excreta is seen at the infestation site. Into biology, here egg period is 7 to 24 days. Egg laid singly on the bark or cracks and suffix on trunk. Grub period is 180 days. It is stocked with well-defined segmentation and yellow in color. Pupation about 19 to 36 days. It's happened inside the tunnel. Here grub bore into the sap wood, making it irregular tunnels. Feeding on the vascular tissues, interruption of nutrition and water transport on tissue, drying of terminal shoot in early stage, and frost come out from several points. And sometimes sap pulls out the hole. Here wilting of branches and or entering. And we can go for tolerant varieties like Neelam, Himayam, and remove and destruction of dead and affected branches of trees. Also avoid the injury at the base of the trunk while pruning. And remove alternate hosts like moringa, silk, cotton in the near vicinity of mango plant. And during the off season, apply absorbent cotton soap in 10 ml of monocrotopost, okay, per tree, by padding without unnecessary injuring the trunk. Okay, use a needle or long wire to pull out the grub from the borehole. The borehole may be filled with dichlorovos at 5 ml, monocrotopos to 10 to 20 ml, or one sulfos tablet. It is just like 3 gram aluminium phosphate. Or apply the carbofuran 5 gram per hole and plug with the clay with the copper oxychloride paste. Okay, and swab coal tar plus kerosene at 1:2 or carbaryl after scraping the loose bark to prevent overpollution by adult bee, and remove and destroy the dead leaf trees affected branch. So main cultural management of regards to stem borer, and also use the one of the listed chemicals to control the stem borer. And coming to bark caterpillar, Indarbella tetronis, Metarbellidae order Lepidoptera. Here, egg period is 8 to 10 days, and larval period is about 1 year, and pupal period is 21 to 28 days, and adult is pale brown moth with 4 wing having brown spot and streak and having white hind wing. And see the picture, both larvae and adults are present. You can manage the pest by keep the orchard clean and healthy, and clean the infested hole and put emulsion of quinol pass 0.05% at each and every holes and plug them with mud. So, drench a stem thoroughly with quinol pass 0.05% chloriperifos. Drenching is one of the effective method, and placement of betrol soaked cotton swab inside the bore hole, and subsequent plugging with the mud also be effective. The damage is caused by grub either to roots or stem. The grub after hatching from egg first feed on bark and make irregular cavity, and it makes tunnels while may either be in boring upward resulting in drying of branches. The caterpillar spin brown zigzag ribbon like silken web on trees, which consist of their excreta and wood bark. Larvae also make a shelter tunnels inside the where they rest in stage. And swabbing padding is recommended for bark caterpillar with the carbaryl and monocrotopos respectively. And coming to shoot webber, Arthaga exviniacea, family Pyrastidae order Lepidoptera. Their egg period is 4 days, larval is 30 days, pupal is 11 to 14 days, adult is grayish with dark patches on wing. Here's symptom of leaf webber or shoot webber is initially the caterpillar feed on leaf surface gregariously by scraping. Later they make web on tender shoot and leaves together and feed within the webbed portion. Several caterpillar may be found in single webbed up cluster of leaves. You can see the both larva and adult in the picture. What about management is the pruning followed by ploughing, and the use of carbaryl or quinol phos it may be effective one. Coming to mango shoot gall psylla, Microceropsylla brevicornis, Psyllidae Hemiptera. Here mango shoot gall psylla is monofocus pest of mango in northern India. Here nymph emerge during the August to September and suck the cell sap from adjacent buds as a result of feeding, but develop into hard conical green galls. The galls are usually seen during September to October. Here there is no flowering and fruit setting. The nymph overwinter inside the galls. And what about management practices? We can go for dimethyote, profenofos, and 2,4-D also recommended. And the orchard is advised to keep it clean and hygienic. Coming to mango shoot borer, Platypeplus Abrobola. Eucosmidae lepidoptera. The genus, otherwise called as Argyroplos Abrobola. A downward tunneling in terminal shoot caused by dark pink caterpillar with dirty spots in seam, and abnormal stunning with bunchy appearance of terminal branches is seen under eye severity of attack by shoot borer. Here larvae bore into the young tender leaves during August and freshly hatched caterpillar bore into midrib. After a couple of days they bore into tender shoots near the growing point and tunneling downwards, throwing their excreta, resulting in dropping of leaves and wilting of terminal shoots. You can see the symptom of mango shoot borer infestation, like deep drying and multiple branch formation. We can use quinol phos at the rate of 0.05% for the effective management. And coming to leaf twisting weevil, Apodorus trancobaricus, family Curculianidae, order Coleoptera. It is a activity from May to October. Grub cut across a leaf from margin to midrib near base. A leaf is then folded longitudinally from tip downwards and compact thimble shaped structure is formed. Unroll gradually, starts drying and ultimately fall down around along with pupa. Here adults are reddish brown weevil with head drawn anteriorly into a long snout and posteriorly into neck. Adult come out by making a small hole in dried rolled mass of leaf. Eggs are oval in shape and yellow in color, and grubs are apodous and pale yellow in color, white pupae and brightish yellow. You can see the leaf twisting weevil in the picture. And coming to red tree ant, Oikophola smaragdina, Formicidae Hymenoptera. Their egg period is 4 to 8 days, larval is 10 to 17 days, pupa is 5 to 7 days, adult is red colored ant. The symptom is it will web and stitch together a few leaves, usually at the top of the branches, and bolt up their nest. The ant are carnivorous and prey upon small insect. However, indirect damage is caused by protecting insect like aphid and scales, which excrete honeydews. You can spray the quinol phos, quinol chloripyrifos or dimethyl for the management of red tree ant. Here nest should be removed and destroyed mechanically or by spraying any of the contact insecticide for the effective management. Coming to leaf feeder, Italia garuda impalidae lepidoptera, butterfly pest, also cause severe defoliation in the case of mango. I can go for any one of the contact insecticide to control the Italia garuda. And coming to sap feeders, king mealybug, Drosicha mangifera, right? Here nymphs and adults suck the plant sap and reduce the vigor of the plant, and mealybug attack every part of the plant. Here eggs deposited as ovi sacs in soil under trees. Nymphal period is about 135 days. It should be oval, flat and body and covered with white mealy powders. Here adult longevity is about 1 month. Here female is wingless, male is winged, and it also caused or formation of sooty mold on mangoes. The mango mealybug, the female adult mealybug crawl down the trees in the month of April to May and enter in the cracks in the soil for regularly. Just after hatching, the minute newly hatched pink to brown colored nymph crawl up the trees, because actually it is called crawlers, and after climbing up the tree they start to suck the sap of tender pots or plant pots. Only nymphs and female mealybugs are harmful, as they suck the plant sap. Male do not eat anything, okay, and They are considered more important because they infest the crop during flowering season, can go for flooding of orchard with water in the month of October to kill the gates, and plowing also recommended. Removal of weed is effective, and planting the alkathing sheet from 25 cm wide, 30 cm above ground level is recommended. Here, destruction of infested fallen leaf in July to August is recommended. Here, leaf symptom is yellowish and mainly cause damage to fruit by sucking sap on stalk with leaf, which leads to drying and dropping of fruit. It also causes root mold and reduce the photosynthesis. The mango mealybug are known to bribe the ant with their sugary secretion honeydews, and in return ants help in spreading of mealybugs and provide the protection from the predator ladybird, beetle, parasites and other natural enemies. You can see the picture of alkathing sheet banding on trees. And coming to leaf gall midge, Amara diplosis amaramide, Cecidomyidae dipterum. Here eggs are laid on under surface of leaves. On hatching, maggots bore inside the leaf tissue and feed within, resulting in formation of small raised wart-like gall on leaves. Here are affected leaves get deformed and drop prematurely. You can go for dimethyl posaconazole or monoclotophos for control the leaf gall midge. And mango scale, two species in mango scale, Chinapsis vitis, Chloropulvinaria sidi, Diaspidida hemipterum. Here nymphs and adults suck the cell sap of leaves and other tender part and reduce the vigor of plant. They also secrete the honeydews, which help in development of sooty mold on the leaves and other tender parts of the leaves. In the case of severe scale infestation, growth and fruit bearing capacity of mango trees will be affected. And what about control? Pruning of heavily infested plant pots and immediate destruction followed by to spray of monocotophos dimethyote the interval of 20 days, which will be a very effective control of scale population. You see the scale attack, scale damage in the pictures. And coming to thrips complex in mango, Citrothrips dorsalis, Calliothrips indigus, Ripiporothrips cruentalis, Megalorothrips distalis, Thripidae thysanoptera. In mango thrips, nymphs and adult lacerate the tissue and suck the oozing the cell sap. Thrips feed on leaves, inflorescence and young fruit. A leaf feeding species feed on mesophyll tissues near leaf tips. Here affected leaves show silverish shines. Okay, silverish shines and leaf edges curl upward and bear small spots of fecal matter. Affected fruits show corky appearance. Okay, corky appearance. You can go for dimethyate monocrotophos for spraying, abamectin, Azadiractin, Deltamethrin, Lambda Cyclothrin or Lufiluron. It's recommended to control the pest. And mango fruit borer, Aelopsila leuconiorella, Physetidae lebraptera. The symptom is the major pest in Orissa and East Bengal and coastal Andhra. The pest is active from January to May. Adult lay eggs on fruit. After hatching, larvae bore into the fruit. Fully grown caterpillar have red band on the body, alternative with white bands. You can see the picture. Their affected fruits get rot and fall prematurely. You can go for Fenthion spray at marble stage to control the pest and repeat the spray with the deltamethrin also. And coming to mango leaf miner, Acroceraops syngrama, Gracilaridae lebraptera. The symptom is tiny caterpillar mine under the dorsal epidermis of tender leaf and feed within the tender leaf. As a result, grayish white blister appear on leaves. Here, management practices clipped and destroy the affected shoots. Also go for insecticide like Guanophos, Fenthium from the emergence of new flush. Now see the termite attack in mango trees. Also use the chloropyrifos for effective management. Here I end my presentation. Thank you.